If you believe the glamour days of cruise ships are gone, when ladies wore glamorous ball gowns to dinner and all rooms had their own hostesses and butlers, you are mistaken. The number of luxury lifestyle opportunities available to us is enormous. Though searching for a one-of-a-kind experience on land yields a prolonged list of possibilities for enjoying the moment, experiential purchases at sea are minimal in comparison to its vastness. However, at sea, the luxurious cruise ships and yachts will have experiences that far outnumber those available on shore. Cruise ships play an important part in satisfying the needs of the multi-billion dollar ocean travel market, since they are more accessible to a vast number of buyers than yachts. These floating cities are redefining luxury travel by providing awe-inspiring views, exquisite, exceptional facilities, and impeccable service to travelers. With rising customer desire and industry competition, cruise ships are regularly enriching cruise experiences with new and imaginative onboard services. Today's seas are swarming with huge cruise ships. As a result, the industry draws billions of dollars in funding per year, allowing for the launch of lavish and costly new vessels. In this video, we'll talk about the most expensive cruises in the world. Our first entry is Scenic Eclipse. Scenic ruffled a few cruise industry feathers as they announced the specs of the Scenic Eclipse, their first Discovery yacht. Many people asked how a ship with only 200 passengers could provide so many dining options, 10 across 7 venues, as well as a pool, bar, theater, submarine, and 2 helicopters. The exterior architecture gives a clear indication of what to expect on the inside of this majestic vessel. Swooping and flowing shapes, expansive proportions, and a thoughtful and cleansing expression of simplicity and shape. The 2-bedroom penthouse suite, which has the finest views on board, is at the top of the scale, but even the veranda suites benefit from the same level of attention to detail and quite good interiors and finishes. Scenic Eclipse is a ship that makes the most of natural light, with sheet after sheet of curved glass that allows visitors to take in every inch of the exterior scenery, perhaps the greatest luxury. Our next entry, Norwegian Epic. The Norwegian Epic, one of Norwegian Cruise Line's most expensive ships, cost $1.2 billion to build due to its unusual shape and scale. The ship has one of the main aquaparks and single passenger cabins. It was the world's third largest cruise ship at the time of its construction, with a capacity of 4,228 passengers. It was recently renovated in 2020, making it a modern luxury travel option. It measures 329.45 meters in length, 52 meters in width, and has a gross tonnage of 155,873. Next is Symphony of the Seas. The Royal Caribbean International Oasis Class cruise ship is the world's largest passenger ship currently in service. As a result, with a manufacturing cost of $1.35 billion, Symphony of the Seas is now one of the most lavish cruise ships in the world. Since it is such a large ship, the interior decor varies greatly from ordinary to higher category spaces. The more unique suites, which have mezzanine and split-level setups with grand pianos, are definitely deserving of appreciation. The cruise, which made its maiden voyage in April 2018, has 18 decks and can accommodate up to 6,680 passengers and a crew of 2,200 people. This lavish cruise ship has 22 bars, 24 pools, a children's amusement park, an ice rink, a full-sized basketball court, and 2 43-foot rock climbing walls, among other amenities. Our next entry is Silver Origin. To sail the Galapagos Islands, ships must follow the Ecuadorian government's strict policies in order to protect this amazing ecosystem. The number of passengers on board is limited to 100, and ships are limited to running only in the Galapagos Islands. Until recently, you had to pick from a fleet of older ships and ships that had been renewed to serve here. Then, there was the unveiling of Silver Origin, Silversea's beautiful new ship designed specifically for this setting. With all balcony accommodations, plenty of deck rooms, 2 bars, an outdoor whirlpool, an observation lounge with a well-stocked library, and a fitness room with spectacular views, this intimate 100-guest ship is supremely luxurious. In addition to the robust shore program and onboard workshops, the base camp, with its incredible interactive wall, offers the opportunity to learn more about the archipelago's flora and fauna. In the evening, passengers can socialize over drinks at the Explorer's Lounge, and after dinner, curl up around the outdoor fire pit. The next one is Crystal Serenity. The interior architecture of this luxury cruise ship, which was built in 2003, is as decadent as the destinations it visits on its around-the-world voyages. It claims to be able to enchant with an unmatched elegant style, with 6-star service, as well as Michelin-level cuisine. It provides a variety of sublime retreats, from suites to penthouses, some with private verandas and attentive butlers, rather than just rooms. Deep padding and quilting on the upholstery and headboards, and also high-end fabrics like marble, luscious leathers, and deep pile velvets, make the furniture elegant without being ostentatious. One of the penthouse rooms also has a Georgian-style wall paneling, walk-in closets, a Swarovski chandelier, and fully lined shades for its wide walls, which is far away from the stereotypical picture of a boat's bedroom. One full-time resident of the Crystal Serenity has lived more than 10 years on the luxury ship. Our next entry is Seabourne Ovation, one luxurious cruise ship devoted to the art world. About 100 artists are represented in the 1,600 pieces of art on display at the Seabourne Ovation. Apart from the art, all rooms of the magnificent 300-suite ship are designed in such a way that the bedroom is either entirely enclosed in its own space or, at least, partition cabinetry is used to separate what is essentially an open-plan room. It's a trick that gives the impression that the suites are much larger. Seabourne Ovation has rapidly gained a reputation for offering high-end entertainment, with 5 restaurants, a salon, and even a casino. Up next, we have Silver Muse. Silver Muse, Silver Sea's newest flagship, is widely regarded as one of the most luxurious cruise ships in the world. Silver Sea's fleet, which accommodates just under 600 passengers, promises small ship intimacy in a luxuriously comfortable setting. Its interiors are more formal in style, with traditional couch forms and window treatments, subdued color schemes, and furniture selections. Our last entry is Seven Seas Explorer. The Regent Seven Seas Explorer has been called the most expensive ship in the world. It is simply immaculate and gives you the same impression as if walking into a high-end hotel. The right scene is set by the sense of style, consistency, and comfort. The oversized chandelier and sweeping staircase in the lobby live up to the cruise line's reputation for lavish architecture, but the overall theme is more simple elegance. The contemporary style persists in the suites, with a cream and blue color scheme. The soft closed drawers, oversized leather wall-mounted headboard, and a waiting bottle of champagne all speak to the high standard. There are larger hotel suites available, but considering that we're at sea, the suites are remarkably spacious and comfortable. The lounge and bedroom are separated by 2 thick curtains, and the balcony is spacious enough for 2 rattan reclining chairs and a walk-in closet. The bathroom is spacious and colorful, with 2 sinks, a large tub, and a separate rainfall shower, as well as black and white marble finish and L'Occitane toiletries. The Explorer, like every other major hotel, has a spa, a sleek gym, a well-stocked library, sophisticated lounge bars, and a large pool deck. Are you looking for elegant and relaxing scenery in a hotel restaurant, as well as efficient service and well-prepared fresh food combined with high-quality wines? On board the Regent Seven Seas Explorer, each of these is easily given, with the trio of specialty restaurants deserving hat tip. A feeling of value while on vacation is a crucial advantage Regent Seven Seas has over its land-based hotel competitors. When compared to premium hotels on shore, Regent Seven Seas boldly promises to have the most inclusive offering at sea. Both dining, branded beverages, and fine wines are included as well, meaning there isn't so much room bill to sign at the end of an evening of cocktails and fine dining. When enjoying the onboard hospitality, you realize how good the value for money is. With this, we conclude our video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if so, then give it a thumbs up and ring the notification bell button for our latest updates. We would love to hear your feedback. Is there anything you want to share with us? Please feel free to mention it in the comment section. If you have any ideas for videos you want to see, do let us know. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.